the readings. Okay, now what you have to do? Yes, you have to calculate this tension. Then you have to find out the square of these things. Okay, so from where you will find out, you have backside, they have given you the squares. Okay, how much it is? 17.5. so what is the reading for where it is 17.5? okay, so this is from 1 to 10, and this is from 10 to 100. So 17 is over here, 17.5. so this is the fifth. So how much it is? 5183. okay, 4.183. so I'll just write here 4.183. then 16.4. so 16.4, 16 and 0.4, matlab ye fourth line mein aapko dekhna hai. so 16 and this is the fourth, 4.050. So if you know how to remove the log, how to use the log table book, then it is so easy for calculation. Otherwise you have to multiply this 17.5 into 17.5, and it will take lot of time. So it's better to see from the square root table. 14.5, where is 14.5? this is 14 and this is fifth column, 3.808. 11.5. so this is 11, okay, and 0.5, this 3.391, and over here unknown length we got 14.4, sorry, here it is 14.4. okay, so 14 and this is fourth line, 3.795. okay, so we have got this. Then what is the homework for you? You have to calculate this column and this column by log. okay, so ye aapka bahut bada number aayega. to yesterday I have told you how to write it. yes, how I have written? Yeah, I have written in the terms of power. So same thing you have to write, 2.45. okay, 2.45, and we have taken the frequency for 512. okay, so here 2.45 into 10 to the power 5. In this way only you have to write it, because this tension column you have to take over here on x axis. okay, see, x axis we have taken the tension. So write it in terms of power, in terms of 10 to the power 5, so that it will be easy for plotting. okay, this is the homework for you. okay, now see, I have done the calculation. Okay, one thing I have to tell you, that in the previous video I have written 2.45 into 10 to the power 5, but here it is about 6, or you may write it as 24.5 into 10 to the power 5. okay, this is the correction. Please do this correction. Now what you have to do? You have to plot the graph, right? So you have to take tension on x axis, L square on y axis. okay, I'll just show you how it looks. See, I have drawn the graph, right? So how I have drawn? I have drawn the series of from 3, okay, and 4 stable I have drawn. okay, so what you have to do? You have to just draw a straight line from here. okay, so what you have to do? Again, in the last video also, what we have done, we have drawn a perpendicular line. So L square of unknown this mass is how much? It is about 3.7, right? So where is 3.7? it is about here. So 3.7 I will take. And then I have to draw a perpendicular line towards this. And this much is, this is 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. Okay, so my one box will be is equal to about 2. Okay, small box. So this is about fourth line. So this will be 12.8. Okay, so this is my unknown tension. Unknown tension. and this unknown tension is into 10 to the power 5. This is tension and this is about L square, that is centimeter square. Okay, and this is tension which is in dyne. Okay, how much it is? 12.8. So this much is your answer. Okay, so 12.8 dyne, and this I am going to write in here. Okay, so we are doing by graph, not by calculation. We are not at all doing by calculation. By graph we are going to find out. Okay, so unknown tension, do the correction, and unknown tension is equal to, by graph it is about 12.8 into 10 to the power 5 dyne. Okay, into 10 to the power 5. So this much is your answer. Then after writing the result, you have to draw the precaution. Okay, now here you can see that the graph of L square against the tree T is straight line, and yes, you can see that, hence the law of tension has been verified. Okay.